Hello, my dear friends. How are you all? I hope the MCQs that we are preparing, you all are preparing from your end as well. And today it is very important video because we are going to discuss all the awards, literary awards, which writers have received and who failed to receive, who received it twice, who received it many times. We all are going to discuss everything in this video. We are going to include as much as possible. So stay tuned with us. Let's begin with question number one.
Question number one. The annual shortlist normally consists of around 6 novels, but in 1975, the shortlist contained how many novels? Question number option A, 3, option B, 9, option C, 10, and option D, 2. So in the year 1975, it contained only 2 novels. Let's see the highlighters for the answer. Heat and Dust by Ruth Prawer Jamwala and Gossip from the Forest by Thomas Kenley were the 2 novels which were included in 1975. This appears perverse given that Malcolm Bradbury's The History Man and David Lodd's Changing Places were eligible that year, to name but 2 worthy alternatives. Heat and Dust won, by the way. Question number 2. 3 of the following writers have been shortlisted in 2 consecutive years. Which one has not? Option A, Beryl Bainbridge. Option B, Roddy Doyle. Option C, Penelope Fitzgerald. Option D, Iris Mudroch. Here, option B is correct, that is Roddy Doyle. Roddy Doyle has not been shortlisted for the same. Mudroch was shortlisted in 1973 and 74, Bainbridge in 73 and 74, Fitzgerald in 78 and 79. Doyle had a year off being shortlisted in 91 and 93. Question number 3. Peter Carey is one of the 2 writers who have won the Booker twice between 1969 and 2002. He did it in 2001 with The True History of Kelly Gang. But what was the name of his previous winner? Option A, Illy Wacker. Option B, Amsterdam. Option C, Jack Mags. And option D, Oscar and Lucinda. So here option D is correct, that is Oscar and Lucinda. Oscar and Lucinda won in 1988. Jack Mags, 1978, didn't make the shortlist. Amsterdam won in 1998, but of course it's by Ian McEwan. Question number 4. Following on from question number 8 up to 2002, who is the only other author to win the Booker Prize? Option A, Faye Weldon. Option B, Salman Rushdie. Option C, J.M. Coetzee. Option D, Graham Swift. So here it is J.M. Coetzee, who is the only other writer to win the Booker Prize twice. Let's see the highlighters. Coetzee has only been shortlisted twice, in 1983 with The Life and Times of Michael Kay and in 1999 with Disgrace and won on both occasions. Rushdie and Swift have each only won once and Weldon has never done so. Question number 5. Martin Amis is one of the UK's most distinguished present-day novelists, but up until now, 2002, he has only once been shortlisted for the Booker. For which novel? Option A, London Fields. Option B, Money. Option C, Times Arrow. And option D, The Rachel Papers. So here it is option C which is correct, that is Times Arrow. Times Arrow was written by Ben Okri's The Famished Road in 1991. Martin's late father, Kingsley, has a much better record with 3 shortlisted novels in a win in 1986 with The Old Devils. Question number 6. 1982's winner was controversial not because of any doubts about its quality, but because of questions about whether it was a novel at all. What was its name? Let's see the options. Empire of the Sun by J.G. Ballard. Option B, Chatterton by Peter Ackroyd. Schindler's Ark by Thomas Kenley. Option D, The English Patient by Michael Ondaatje. Here option C is correct, that is Schindler's Ark by Thomas Kenley. Kenley insisted that his book was a novel based on real events. The same could have been said of Empire of the Sun, shortlisted in 1984, and based on the author's experiences as a child in the Second World War. Neither Peter Ackroyd nor Michael Ondaatje made any such claim for their works. Question number 7. As we discussed back in question number 4, Beryl Benbridge holds the record for most appearances on the shortlist without even having won. But which writer has been shortlisted in total more than any other? Option A, Bernice Rubens. Option B, A.S. Bratt. Option C, Ian McEwan. Option D, Iris Murdoch. Here, option D is correct, that is Iris Murdoch. Murdoch's 6 shortlistings include winning the Sea in 1978. M.C. Ewans won it. He was shortlisted for 4 times. Rubens was shortlisted for 2 times and Bratt once. Question number 8. It is often said that books set in India are a shoo-in to win the Bookers. 3 out of the following novels certainly did. So which one didn't? Option A, The Seas of Krishnapur by J.G. Farrell. Option B, Saying On by Paul Scott. Option C, The God of Small Things by Arundhati Roy. Option D, A Fine Balance by Rohinton Mistry. So it is option D, A Fine Balance by Rohinton Mistry. Mistry's novel was beaten by Graham Swift's Last Orders in 1996. The Seas of Krishnapur won in 1973. Staying On in 1977 and The God of Small Things in 1997. Question number 9. One of the most enjoyable Booker tradition is the post-award disagreements among the judges. So, which winner did panelist Dr. Julia Neuberger succinctly describe as crap? Option A, A Bone People by Carrie Holmes. Option B, How Late It Was, How Late by James Kelman. Option C, Hotel Du Lac by Anita Brockner. And option D, Paddy Clark, Ha 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 by Roddy Doyle. So here option B is correct, that is How Late It Was, How Late by James Kelman. Kelman's book is a stream of consciousness monologue by a blind, drunken Glaswegian. Question number 10. This author won the Pulitzer Prize winning for A Bell for Adano. Option A, John Steinbeck. Option B, John Shiver. Option C, John Updike. And option D, John Hersey. Here, option D is correct, that is John Hersey. John Hersey is the author who won the Pulitzer Prize for A Bell for Adano. This author won the prize for A Bell for Adano. Shiver won for his short stories. Updike won for some of his rabbit books. Steedberg won for Grapes of Wrath. Another Pulitzer Prize winner was Anderson Vale. Who wrote it? Option A, Thornton Wilder. Option B, Mac Kinley Cantor. Option C, Nat Styron. Option D, Booth Tarkington. Here, option B is correct, that is Mac Kinley Cantor. He is the writer of Anderson Wheel. Wilder won for Bridge of San Luis Rey. Styron won for Nat Turner's Rebellion. Option C, Tarkington won more than once. Question number 12. Who wrote The Yearling? Option A, Marjorie Kinas Rawlings. Option B, Alice Walker. Option C, Paul Buck. Option D, Edna Ferber. So here option A is correct, that is Marjorie Kinas Rawlings. Walker won for The Color Purple. Buck won for The Good Earth. And Ferber won for So Big. Question number 13. The first Nobel Prize for Literature was awarded in 1901. Which of these poets, most famous for Les Vies Brisses, won that award? Option A, Johnston Johnson, Giosu Carducci, Jos Echegaray, Sully Prudhomme. So here, correct option is option D, that is Sully Prudhomme. In 1865, Prudhomme published his first collection, Stanzas and Poems, which included Les Vies Brisses. Later in his life, his writings began reflecting his philosophical interests. The prize money was used to establish a poetry prize to be awarded by the Société des Gens de Lettres, founded by Honor de Balzac, Victor Hugo, Alexandre Dumas, and George Sand in 1838. Question number 14. In 1913, it was the first time a non-European had been awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature. Which of these prolific authors was born in Calcutta and authored poems, novels, short stories, songs, and essays? Option A, Carl Adolf Gellerup. Option B, Maurice Maeterlinck. Option C, Karl Spittler. And option D, Rabindranath Tagore. So it is option D which is correct, that is Rabindranath Tagore. Poems that he had written in 8 years of age were not published until he was 16. Two of the songs he composed were chosen to be national anthem, the Republic of India's Janaganamana and Bangladesh Amar Shonar Bangla. He also authored plays, short stories and novels. Question number 15. During 1930 award ceremony, his Babbitt was praised. Which of these was the first US author awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature? Option A, Sinclair Lewis. Option B, Grazia Deleda. Option C, Henry Bergeon. And option D, Thomas Mann. Here, option A is correct, that is Sinclair Lewis. Lewis' first published works were included in the Yale Courant and the Yale Literary Magazine, where he attended from 1903 until receiving his bachelor's degree in 1908. Lewis was a commercial success after publishing Man Street in 1920. Question number 16. Which of these women authors, also known by her Chinese name of Sai Zhenzu, was the first US woman to be awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature? Option A, Jacinto Benaventi, Sigrid Undset. Option D, Paul S. Buck. And option D, Anatole France. So it is P.S. Buck or Paul S. Buck, who was also known by her nickname Sai Zhenzu. Buck won the Nobel Prize in 1938 for her rich and truly epic description of peasant life in China and for her biographical masterpieces. Though born in West Virginia, her missionary family returned to China when she was about 3 months old. Paul spent most of her time there until 1934. Question number 17. In 1948, the Nobel Prize for Literature was given to a poet. Which of these became famous from the poem The Love Songs of J. Alfred Prufrock? Option A, George Herbert. Option B, Robert Burns. Option C, William Sandstone. And option D, T.S. Eliot. So it is option D, that is T.S. Eliot, which is correct. Thomas Stearns, or T.S. Eliot, was born in U.S. in 1888. He moved to the United Kingdom when he was 25 and was naturalized as a British subject when he was 39. Naturalized as a British subject when he was 39. The poem The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock was published in 1915. In addition, he authored 7 plays. Question number 18. In 1953, Nobel Prize for Literature was awarded to each Englishman who is better remembered as a politician than an author. Option A, Anthony Eden. Option B, Winston Churchill. Option C, Harold Macmillan. And option D, Clement Attlee. So it is Winston Churchill who has received Nobel Prize for Literature, but he is known more than as a politician. Although Churchill is remembered for his leadership of the United Kingdom during World War II, he began his working life as a journalist. The majority of his work are historical and biographical, although he also wrote one novel, Savrola, published in 1899. Churchill received the Nobel Prize primarily for his 6-volume history called The Second World War. Question number 19. In 1958 saw the award of the Nobel Prize for Literature to which Russian author? The author of Dr. Zivago. Option A, Boris Pasternak. Option B, Mikhail Solovkov. Option C, Alexander Solzhenitsyn. And option D, Ivan Bunin. Here, option A is correct, that is Boris Pasternak, who is the author of Dr. Zhivago. Dr. Zhivago was originally published in Milan in 1957, having been smuggled out of USSR as it then was, where it had been banned. Pasternak's award of the Nobel Prize the following year caused great humiliations to his country, and he was forced to decline the prize. The film of the book, starring Omar Sharif and Julie Christie, came out in late 1965 in the USA and won several Academy Awards, including for art direction and adapted screenplay. All the options are Russian winners of Nobel Prize for Literature. Bunin won in 1933, Sholokhov in 1965, and Solzhenitsyn in 1970. Question number 20. French writer Jean-Paul Sartre won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1964. Which of these works was his? Option A, L'Isle des Pingouins or Penguin Island. L'Estranger, The Stranger. Option B, option C, Huis Close, No Exit. Option D, Invitation. So here it is option C which is correct, that is Huis Close. Apart from being an author, Sartre was also known as a philosopher, screenwriter, politician, political activist, especially in Marxism. Huis Close was published in 1944 and is a play about three dead people being coffined in one room together with no way out. It includes Sartre's famous comment, "Hell is other people." Comment, "Hell is other people." The other work are also, other works are also by French Nobel laureates. L'Estranger was written by 1957 winner Albert Camus, and L'Invitation by Claude Simon, who won in 1985. Antoine France won the award in 1921, and among his works, The Isle des Penguins include. Dear friends, by this we have completed MCQs on award winners and their work as well. I hope it is going to be helpful for you all, and whatever is your comment, do let us know, and if you require anything else, do comment in the comment box.